Artificial intelligence is a rather fuzzy concept and actually not that easy to define for three reasons. The first, already human intelligence is quite difficult to describe, and as such, artificial intelligence obviously is also difficult to define. Second, and this is called the AI effect, artificial intelligence is somehow a moving target. Whenever people get used to what an AI system is able to do, they usually don't consider it as being intelligent any longer, and as such, they don't talk about artificial intelligence anymore. And third, AI arrives in a variety of different types, sorts, and evolutionary stages, ranging from artificial narrow intelligence to general to super intelligence, which all represent different nuances of AI, but which are nevertheless mixed up with each other. Therefore, and to bring it all together, we define artificial intelligence as a system's ability to interpret external data correctly, to learn from such data, and to use these learnings to achieve specific goals and tasks through flexible adaptation.
Today, firms use artificial intelligence mainly in three different areas. The first is to optimize the company-customer interface. Think of evolutions like speech recognition or the use of chatbots, for example. The second area is pattern recognition. For example, the automatic detection of faces in social networking sites or the detection of credit card fraud. And the last one is optimization. Think, for example, of the placement of an ad on a web page using an approach called reinforcement learning. In future, I think we will see those same three areas, but on a different level. Systems will be able to recognize emotional cues based on facial micro-impressions, for example. Or they will be used to optimize much more complex decisions like inventory management or order forecasting. In addition, there will be a stronger interaction between the physical world and AI systems through the use of service robots, for example, or self-driving cars. And finally, AI will be used to support creative tasks. For example, the automated mining of patent databases in order to identify new ideas for research and development.
Early systems of AI tried to formalize and to reconstruct human intelligence in a top-down approach as a series of if-then statements. However, these early so-called expert systems were not able to learn by themselves, but followed the exact rules as they were programmed by humans. As such, one could actually argue that these early systems were not real artificial intelligence, following at least our aforementioned definition. Today's AI systems apply a bottom-up approach, which is based on techniques such as artificial neural networks or deep learning, which makes it possible to solve a lot more complex goals and tasks. However, there's a catch to these new systems of AI. Today's systems are more prone to bias since they learn from potentially already biased data which are fed to them. In comparison to earlier systems, top-down systems which were rule-based and as such way less opaque and more transparent.
There are many concepts that have been developed by the early pioneers of artificial intelligence that are still relevant today. Think of the Turing test developed by Alan Turing, which even today is still considered as the gold standard when designing human-machine interfaces. The Turing test essentially states that a customer interacting with a machine would not be able to tell whether she is talking to a machine or to another person. Other concepts are the idea of Hebbian learning developed by Donald Hebb, which is the foundation of artificial neural networks or deep learning. Coming back to the question of bias, the question whether these systems are more or less biased depends on the type of data they are learning from. If the input data used for artificial intelligence is biased itself, because it has been generated by humans with biased decision-making, think of court rulings that have racial bias or loan approval processes at banks that have been biased, then these biases will carry over into the systems and probably even be amplified. If the input data is less biased, let's say, for example, stock market data, then decisions taken by artificial intelligence systems will be much less biased than those of human observers. This explains the increasing rise of robo-advisors that are currently in the process of transforming the financial services industry.
AI regulation is actually strongly needed, but this is not an easy achievement since the technologies itself change constantly. Therefore, instead of trying to regulate the technology itself, it is probably easier to come up with a set of commonly accepted requirements with regards to the training and testing of AI algorithms. Regulation is also difficult since it sets often barriers to innovation. As such, too much or the wrong regulation can lead to companies in one region becoming less competitive in comparison to companies in other regions of the world, which is obviously to be avoided. Therefore, governments across the planet have the important role of finding the right balance between innovation and regulation to definitely strongly cooperate with each other and to design the rules of the game in a way that the human stays at the center of all these developments and potential changes triggered by AI in the future.
The managers of the future will need to consider AI and the associated systems of automation as a central part of their future workforce. This often leads to the question of job displacement and the issue whether in 10 or 20 years' time, most humans will lose their jobs to a machine. Personally, I think this fear tends to be largely overstated. An average employee performs dozens, if not hundreds, of different tasks on a given day, and only few of them can actually be taken over by a machine. Taking into account the huge cost of procuring such systems, of customizing them, of maintaining them, it seems unlikely that firms will replace employees by machines on a large scale if those machines can perform only part of the jobs that humans did before. Instead of talking about job displacement, I think we should talk about job enhancement, because AI systems will allow humans to perform their jobs in a much more efficient way. An example is the use of smart glasses that can help service employees to detect emotional cues of their clients and interact in an appropriate manner based on those. Very broadly speaking, today we are in a limbo because we are facing a lot of different challenges. Think of climate change, security issues, the issues in healthcare that we are not able to address with the current solutions we have. We strongly believe that AI will allow to provide new avenues to solve these problems, and that by consequence, the world in 20 years with AI will be a better one than the world today. But as always, only future can tell.